In this video, we are going to update the roguelike project to Godot 4. The first step is to open Godot 4 and import the project. Select Convert Full Project and then OK. As it says, make sure you have a copy of the project just in case. After a few seconds, the project conversion will have finished. Open the project. Play the project to see what's the first thing that crashes. The problem is related with the character class. Let's check it. The first problem is the icon. To define an icon for a class in Godot 4, we have to put it inside the icon on the first line. Next, it seems the converter has trouble with exported variables and duplicates their type, so delete the duplicate. We also have an error on the declaration of the velocity variable. In Godot 4, selector body 2D, the equivalent of kinematic body 2D in Godot 3, already has a velocity property, so we don't need to declare it ourselves. Also, the converter generated some weird lines on the physics process function. Delete the velocity equal velocity and set velocity lines. They don't make any sense. Now that you know how to do it, fix all the errors related with the icon and the exported variables for all the classes. Let's continue. The next error is on the player script. To remove an element at a specific index of an array, now we have to use the removeAdd function instead of remove. The equivalent of addChild below node in Godot 4 is addSibling, and it works different. Instead of calling the function from the parent, we have to call it from the node where we want to add the dust below, the node above the player. We only have to pass the dust, and it will be added below the node. Next, we have the wire script of the weapons. The twin node got deprecated on Godot 3.5, and they removed it on Godot 4. So we have to replace it with the new twin created by code. So, delete the twin node and the onReady variable. In the rechargeAbility animation function, change the ability icon value to 100, since we can't specify an initial value with the new twin. Next, create a twin with the createTwin function and interpolate the value to 0, using the time parameter. Remove the code of the previous twin. Notice that we are not calling start. The new twins start automatically. On weapon.gd, we have another twin. Initialize the twin to null and remove the onReady. Next, replace stopAll by kill and replace the position interpolation in the same way we did before. To apply a different type of transition, I call the setTrans of the twinner. To change his is, I call the setIs function. We also have to connect the finished signal so the onTwinTwinCompleted function is called when the twin ends. Another problem are the show and hide functions. For some reason, we can't override them anymore, so change their names to onShow and onHide, and remove the call to show and hide. Then, add the ready function, connect the draw signal with the onShow function, and the hidden signal with the onHide signal. This way, they will be called when we show the weapon and hide it respectively. Also, let's make sure the twin is not null before calling kill on it. Fix the rest of the twins following the same pattern. Let's check the next error. Set size on a null value. I used this code to center the window, but it seems it's not necessary anymore. The window gets centered automatically, so just delete the code. We have an error on set collision mask value of weapon.gd. It seems now the layers are between 1 and 32, and not 0 and 31, like before. So add 1 to each one of them. Change the class of rooms.gd to node2d. Navigation2d does not exist anymore. The type already changed to Node 2D on the sentry. In Godot 4, there is a new vector 2 type for integers, and it can be added with the vector 2 for floats. In this line, local2map returns an integer vector, so we have to change vector2.down to vector2i.down to add the two vectors. Playing is no longer a property of animated sprite, so replace playing equal true with the play function on the spawn explosion script. Let's fix the enemy navigation. In the new navigation system, to move a character, we have to add a navigation agent node to it. We also have to change some things on the script. There is not a navigation 2D node anymore, so delete the onReady variable. Delete the path variable, we don't need it anymore. Create an onReady variable for the navigation agent. We are going to use this node to get the movement direction. On the change function, replace if path with not navigation agent is target rigid. Remove the code we used to delete points from the path array. We don't need it anymore. When we get the direction of the path, replace path 0 with the return value of navigation agent dot get next path position. This will return the next point of the path the navigation agent calculated. Remove the line where we empty the path, and on the getPathToPlayer function, instead of changing the value of path, update the target position property of the navigation agent. The navigation agent will create a path to the new target position and delete the points of the path automatically as we reach them. The setCellB function does not exist anymore. We have to use setCell. We can leave the parameters we used with setCellB, but we have to add a parameter for the layer at the start. I'm going to use 0. That's a new feature in Godot 4. Instead of creating multiple tilemaps, you can create multiple layers on the same tilemap. After all that, the game runs, but the tilemaps don't appear and we can move. At least it does not crash anymore. Before checking these problems, let's take a look at the errors. It seems there is a problem with the shader. It's missing a semicolon. I don't know if it was already missing from before or the converter did it, but just add it. After that, we don't get errors anymore on the debugger. Okay, Godot decided to delete all the tiles. I guess we will have to create the rooms again. But what I'm going to show first is how to add navigation to the tiles, because the navigation has not been ported to Godot 4. Click the tilemap and select a floor tile. Then, go to the tileset, click the three dots, and click Reset to Default Tile Shape. This will create a navigation that fills the tile. We can also add points, but this way is faster. Add navigation to the other floor tiles too. Now, when I open the project, the tiles appear but are incorrect. I don't know what's the problem with Godot. Anyway, it seems the tiles have an ID 1 unit less than they showed. Increase the ID by 1 for each tile, and change the ID of the last to 0. The tiles are correct now, except for some offset of the bottom tiles. This is because I think I moved the tilemap by accident. It gets fixed resetting the position to 0,0. I tried reimporting another copy of the project and the tilemaps converted without problem. I don't know what happened with this project, but if you have the same problem, now you know how to fix it. The next problem is the corridors. They don't appear. With the conversion, the individual tiles got converted to atlas tiles with only one tile each one. Because we are using atlas tiles, when we call setCell, we have to indicate the coordinate of the tile we want to set. As we have seen, each atlas only has one tile, so his coordinate is always 0,0. Add a vector2i .0 when you call setcell. The tilemap is all good now. Let's fix the movement. Some input keys, the throw key and the movement keys, have been changed to unset. Put back the corresponding keys. We can move now. Why is the game zoomed out so much? Enter the window configuration and change the straight mode to canvas item. This way, the game resolution will be scaled to fit the window instead of the resolution increasing with the window. The zoom is fine now. However, it seems the problems never end. We can see two more. The game is blurred and it seems the animation does not loop. The first problem has an easy fix. In Rudo 3, we re-imported the texture to change the filter. Now, this can be changed on each node. We could set the filter of each sprite, but it's not necessary. The only filter we have to change is that of the game node to nearest to make the pixel art look good. Because by default, the filter is set to inherit, all the sprites will inherit the nearest filter and the game won't look blurry anymore. About the animations, enable the loop button on the idle and move animations. When we start the game, we see an error that says that the charge shader uses an old deprecated parameter names. Go to the charge animation and change param to parameter of the path of the shaded parameter. Also, the charge particles material change it to the default values or something, so tweak some properties and make the particles look cool again. It looks good, but we still have the warnings. They will get fixed later. Replace all the types of the parameters used on BodyEnter and BodyExited with Node2D, otherwise we get an error when the hitbox hits a tilemap collision. But now, when a projectile collides with a tile, the body will not be null anymore. It will be the tilemap object. The same happens if a projectile hits a door. So, instead of body not equal to null, put body.hasMethodTakeDamage. This way, we will only damage the bodies that have the takeDamage function. Let's check the next problem. When the door opens, an error is generated. It says we can make the polygon of the occluder with less than 2 points. So, instead of changing the points of the occluder's polygon, change the light mask. When the door opens, disable the first bit to make the light pass. Play the game. It still works and we don't get the error anymore. Another odd thing happened. Now, the active ability animation of the sword changed to the active ability of the crossbow. It seems there is a problem with the animation's inheritance. So if you have the same problem, delete all the animations from the weapon scene and remake all the animations for each weapon. Here are the new animations. At the time I started with the tutorials, there still was not the reset animation thing. If you remake the animations like I did and added the default values in the reset animation, you don't need the cancel attack animation anymore. Use reset in his place. The previous warnings also disappeared. Let's fix one last thing. The game crashes when we throw a weapon. The problem is we are waiting until the twin of the weapon we want to drop enters the tree, but the twin is null. So, instead, wait for the tree entered signal of the weapon instead of the twin. This fixes the problem. But we get another error. The problem is the twin completed function must not have parameters now, because we are using the new twin. So, remove the parameters. Finally, it all works now. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.